Hello and welcome to Amulya's Academy YouTube channel. In the previous tutorial, we saw how to find the shortest path between given two nodes using BFS algorithm. BFS algorithm can be used to find the shortest path in unweighted graph or weighted graph where all the edges have same weight. But what if I want to find the shortest path in the weighted graph where all the edges have different weight? For that, you can use Dijkstra algorithm. Dijkstra's algorithm is one of the fundamental algorithms in computer science, was introduced by Dutch computer scientist Edsger Dijkstra in 1956 and published in 1959. Using this Dijkstra algorithm, we can find the shortest path between two nodes, or you can find the shortest distance from one node to all other nodes in the graph. Let's see how to do that, how this algorithm works. In this algorithm, we'll find the shortest path or distance from source node to all other nodes in the graph. And the first step is initialization. We need to assign distance value to each node. Distance of source node is 0. For other nodes, initially take distance as infinity. Next, we need to create a priority queue to store the nodes with its distance. And the second step is we need to process nodes. First, remove the node with the smallest distance. Update distance for its neighbors. For each neighbor of the current node, calculate the distance from source node to neighbor by adding current node distance and edge weight. If new distance is smaller than the recorded distance, update distance and add it to priority queue. Repeat this until queue becomes empty. Last step is termination. Algorithm terminates when priority queue is empty. We'll have shortest distance from the source node to all other nodes. Confusing, right? Let's take an example and we'll see how this works. Before that, this Dijkstra algorithm picks the node with the smallest distance first and process it. For example, here, after visiting A, this algorithm will process B, node B, because it has smallest distance, 3. After that, it will process or visit C. Dijkstra algorithm makes the greedy choice of picking the node with the smallest distance at each step. For this purpose, we need to use priority queue instead of normal queue. This is Dijkstra algorithm's greedy nature. Next, let's take an example. Let's take a graph and we'll see how Dijkstra algorithm finds the shortest distance from a source node to all other nodes. So in this graph, let's take A as the source node. So the first step is we need to assign distance to every node of the graph. For distance A, 0, because source node is A, so its distance is 0. For all other nodes, take distance as infinity. Then we need to create a queue, priority queue. So initially what I need to do is I need to add this starting node with distance 0 to queue. Because its distance is 0, right? This is the shortest distance of the nodes. Initially, for A, that is 0 because it is source node. For all other nodes, take distance as infinity. Then in the queue, add the first node, that is the starting node, with distance 0 to the queue. Next, you need to remove the node from the queue. So, removed node is this A. So, it will become our current node. And current distance becomes 0. Current node is A and current distance is 0. Next, we need to find the adjacent node of A. So B, D, F are the adjacent node of A. And here you need to find its distance. To find the distance, we'll use this formula, current distance plus weight. So here current distance is 0 and weight of B, that is 1. You can use this also. Here you can see from A to B. Weight is 1. This is the dictionary representation of the graph. So 0 plus 1 is 1. For this 0 plus 4. So 4. 0 plus 7. So 7. So we'll find the distance. Next, I need to check whether this new distance is less than the smallest distance. Smallest distance of nodes will be stored here. And you need to compare that with this new distance. If this new distance is smaller, then update the distance here. Here 1 is less than infinity, so we need to update that. And 4 is less than infinity, so update that. and here 7. And we need to add this node to Q with its distance. So 1B, 4D and 7F. Next, we need to remove the node from the Q. So here 1 is the smallest distance here. So it will remove this node. So current node becomes B and distance becomes 1. B and distance is 1. So find the adjacent node of B. Adjacent node of B is C and A, right? And find the new distance, current distance plus weight. Current distance is 1 and weight is, for C it is 3 and for A it is 1. So here 4 and 2. Then compare new distance with the smallest distance. For C, here you can see it is infinity. 4 is less than infinity. So update it here. 4 and also add this node to priority queue, 4C. And for A, it is 2 and here smallest distance is 0. 2 is not less than 0, so skip it. No need to do anything. No need to add it to queue and no need to update the new distance. And again, remove the node from the queue, 4D, 7F and 4C. And here smallest distance is 4. It will remove 4D. Actually, in priority queue, when priority is same, it depends on the type of the queue. Here 4D is inserted first, so we'll remove that. So here current node is D and distance is 4. And find the adjacent node of D. Here D, A, C, G, I. Use this formula to find the new distance. Current distance plus weight. Current distance is 4 and add weight for A from D, so 4, for C, 5, for G, it is 2, and for I, it is 3. 4 plus 4, 8, right? And its distance is not smaller than the smallest distance of A, because smallest distance of A is 0, so skip it. No need to add it to Q, and no need to update the distance. Here, 4 plus 5, 9. For C, new distance is 9, but here smallest distance is 4. 4 is smaller than 9, so no need to add it to Q, no need to update new distance. Here 4 plus 2, it is 6. And for G, here you can see distance of minimum distance of G is infinity and 6 is smaller than infinity, so update it and add it to Q, that is 6G. And here 4 plus 3 is 7 for I. So here I is infinity. So update it 7 and add it to Q. Next, again, remove the node from the Q. It will remove 4C and adjacent node of C. Find adjacent node of C. So C is for B. Find the new distance. So current distance is 4. And weight of B is 3, so we'll get 7. Then compare new distance with the smallest distance here. It is 1 for B, so 7 is not smaller than 1, so no need to add it to Q and no need to update the distance. For E, here current distance is 4 and this distance is 4 and here infinity, so 8 is smaller than infinity, so update it 8 and add it to Q. That is 8E. And for H, 4 plus 5, 9. Add it to Q. Compare new distance with the smallest distance. Right? Here, done. Then, next, remove the node from the Q. Here, 6G is removed from the Q. Here, current node is G. And this is 6. And find the adjacent node of G. G, adjacent node of G is... here H and D. So current distance is 6 plus the G to H is 1, so 7. And for D, current distance is 6 and G to D is 2, 8. So for H, smallest distance is 9 but new distance is 7, that is smaller, so update it. Then add it to Q. And for D, smallest distance is 4. Here 8 is greater than 4, so no need to add it. Skip it. Next, again, remove the node from the queue. Here we can see 7f, 7i, 7h. There are three nodes with distance 7. So it will remove 7f first. So adjacent node of f, only a, right? And for a, current distance is 7 plus here weight is 7, that is 14. Here smallest distance of a is 0. No need to update it, right? So skip it. Next, again, remove another node. That is, let's remove 7i. So node is I, distance is 7. Adjacent node of I. Adjacent node of I is D. And current distance is 7 plus its weight is 3, 10 for D. But smallest distance of D is 4. So 10 is greater than 4. So no need to update new distance and no need to add it to queue. So skip it. Next, remove a node from the queue and 7h is removed. So current node is h and distance is 7. Adjacent node of h, c and g. So current distance is 7. For c, from h, that is 5. And for g, 1. So here 7 plus 5 is 12. 7 plus 1 is 8. So for C, here we can see minimum distance is 4, new distance is 12. So no need to update it, skip it. For G, here G is 6 and here we can see 8. So no need to update the distance, skip it. So next, remove the node from the queue, 8E, remove that. Current node is E, current distance is 8. Adjacent node of E. Adjacent node of E is C and distance is, so here current distance is 8 and so we'll get 12, but here smallest distance for C is 4. So 12 is greater than 4. No need to update the new distance and skip it. Next, here in the queue we have 9H. So current node is H. Current distance is 9. But here you can see current distance is greater than here this distance for H, H is 7, which is smaller than 9. So no need to check for new distance actually. If you want to check also, then here you can see in H, it is C and G, for C and G. So 5 plus 9, that is 14 for C, but here C is 4. And for G, it is 1 plus 9, 10. But here for G, it is 6. So no need to check for any nodes, skip it. So Q becomes empty. So we are done here. So here we can see all the smallest distance from the A to all other nodes. Alright, so this is how actually algorithm works. So that's it for now guys. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel. I will meet you in next class. Till then, take care.